just not functional in front of many people. I think it's very clear that what we're seeing around us is actually an insult to the very idea of our constitution. What we have committed to ourselves when this country got independent and when the constitution got created, I think the vision that was enshrined in the constitution, especially of equality, I think what we're seeing around us, including the GST taxation structure, is essentially a violation of that condition. And I think while we're talking about GST on handmade, I think something that we've got to reiterate is what happens when you get into highly centralized decision making. And that's precisely what we're seeing in action in this entire GST business. When the chief minister of a state, like Karnataka, writes to the center, it holds no weight anymore. It has no value anymore. And this is not just party dynamics. It's the fact that we have left very, very crucial decisions to very centralized structures of decision making. There may be a semblance of participation. You may find state government representatives sitting in the council and so on. But the real superstructures which are taking these decisions are completely out of the control of even our national governments. You know, in investment treaties like the BITs, bilateral investment treaties, and the free trade agreements that we are getting into, governments don't have any power if big, capitalist forces want to take you to the kind of litigation structures that suit them. They are completely, useless and weak. And it falls upon us to save our democracy and to save our governments from those kinds of structures, unfortunately. Last time when two council meetings ago, when they did make this announcement, some of us went to the social media with a lot of flutter, happy flutter, saying that yes, today, because the press release from the PIB said that they were going to exempt several items, 29 items like you said, and then one finds that no such decision is actually recorded and obviously no implementation because they didn't mean it, they didn't discuss it. I think one other fight that many of us in the party movements are waiting at this point of time is a new rule in the name of food safety, where every organic farmer in this country is being asked to certify herself as being organic. Every organic farmer, if anything has to be sold as organic there, they're supposed to be certified, which means that, if you opt for somebody else to inspect on your farm, you have to end up paying 10 to 25,000 rupees per farmer to just call yourself organic and to be able to sell it as organic. And if you opt for a highly dysfunctional government system that exists there, there's absolutely no hope that you will get certified as organic. And that's coming into effect from tomorrow. Many of us are putting up a tough fight on that, and I think we should join hands. This is one more such regulation, and all these regulations, taxation structures and so on are the ways by which you actually remove Bharat from the picture and leave your shining India only to thrive out there. And while the interpretation being given for Hey Ram as one which reminds the Modi government about the Ram Rajya that they are supposed to be based upon, I think that Hey Ram of January 30th, 1948, which is also a very symbolic Hey Ram, the end to those things which hold the potential for transformational change in this country. I think what we're seeing at this point of time is truly a moment where we're left with having to say Hey Ram But I think we'll fight this back. And on the GST fight, I'm sure there'll be a victory soon, and we should just move ahead stronger than we are today. Thank you.